Hey, this is Deepak here from digitaldeepak.com and welcome to lesson 6 of your AdWords Mastery Home Study course. So in this lesson, we will learn about conversions and landing pages. So let's get started. A short introduction to the marketing funnel. This you have to understand in general, clicks do not bring revenue, sales do. So your marketing funnel has to be designed in such a way that the clicks and visitors lead to sales. So clicks should lead to a highly targeted landing page. So one of the biggest secrets in making Google AdWords work is that when people click on your AdWords ads and when they land up on your website, the website landing page should be very specific to the ad that they have clicked on. Otherwise, the conversions are not going to happen. Keywords and ad copy should match. Ad copies and landing pages should match. And this gives a consistent experience for the users. So if you are, let's say, searching for something and if you are looking at an ad, you expect the landing page to match with the ad, right? So that is the consistent experience that every internet user wants. Landing pages should be focused on lead generation. This is for B2B. So if you are promoting e-commerce through shopping ads or if you are trying to sell something online, that is fine. But if you are in a B2B space, you should not drive people directly to something that you are selling. Instead, you should do lead generation. And then you should be doing inside sales to convert these leads into customers. So AdWords clicks work well when you lead them to a landing page with a lead generation form. So let's look at Google AdWords conversion tracking. Conversion optimization and conversion tracking itself is a very huge concept. But in this lesson, we are going to look at conversion tracking only from the AdWords perspective. So what you have to do is you have to add the conversion tracking code on the thank you page that comes after the landing page. So let's take the example of my own landing page, learndigitalmarketing.com. So as soon as people come to the landing page, if they fill up the form, they go to a thank you page which comes after the landing page, right? So here we have to place the conversion tracking code, and that is how Google or any other tool will know that that particular click has actually converted. We will look at this in depth with an example. So you can track the conversion from your AdWords dashboard. I will show it to you how it can be done. Conversion codes helps in conversion tracking and also conversion optimization. So in this course, we have only looked at manual CPC bidding, but there are also automatic bidding strategies. So these automatic bidding strategies will be helpful if you are targeting the ads for conversions rather than for clicks. So you have to track cost per conversion for long-term business growth, not just the cost per click, because cost per click does not matter. What really matters is the cost per conversion that you are getting. So in this image, you can see that there is a website where the ad is displayed, and then you have the landing page, and then you have the thank you page. So this website could be a search engine, it could be a search engine marketing ad, or it could be a website where you are putting up your display banner ad as well. So let's say someone is clicking on that and they go to a landing page and they complete registration. After they complete the registration on the landing page, they will go to the thank you page, right? So what happens is that when this happens in the same session using the same computer, using a particular internet connection, using the same IP address, the technology can track that this particular person who came to the thank you page came from this particular ad, and that is how conversion tracking works. So there is a technology called pixel firing technology, which is basically a 1 pixel by 1 pixel image that loads on that particular page. So the pixel fires from the same browser where the ad was clicked, and this confirms the user has signed up. Conversion tracking really does not help if you have only one campaign and if you have only one landing page. It helps when you have multiple campaigns and you are driving the traffic to the same landing page using multiple campaigns. You need to know which campaigns are performing well. That is where the conversion tracking really helps. So tracking two campaigns and sources. So this is how we do. So let's say the first website where the ad is displayed, it's marked in green here. So let's say 100 clicks are driven from this website to the landing page. And out of these 100 clicks, only 20 actually convert and go to the thank you page. The overall conversion is 50 leads, but only 20 from the first ad go to the thank you page, because that is the quality of traffic from the first ad. Let us look at the second ad, which is marked in red here. So here, when 100 clicks come to this landing page, let's say since the quality of traffic is better from this particular campaign or from this particular source, let's say 30 people are converting into a lead from this particular page. So what happens is that even though you have driven 200 clicks and 50 leads, if you don't have conversion tracking, you will only know that you have generated 50 leads from 200 clicks, but you will not know which particular website or which particular campaign is performing better. So without knowing that, you will not be able to scale up. So here, since we are doing conversion tracking using the pixel technology, we know that the second ad is performing better because the second ad is driving 30% conversion, first ad is driving only 20% conversion. So what we can do is that if we are scaling up the advertising budget, we can actually focus on the second ad rather than the first. So this is how conversion tracking helps. So conversion cost reporting for campaigns and conversion tracking inside Google AdWords looks like this. So here you can see there are two campaigns. First one is free LDM and second one is LDM. And you can see that we have spent different amount of budget on both these campaigns. First one is $42, second one is $12. But the first one has got 32 converted clicks, second one has got 12 converted clicks. But which campaign is performing better? We have to look at the conversion cost, right? So when you look at the rightmost column, cost per converted click is just $1.06 for the second campaign, but for the first campaign, it is $1.34. So even though the first campaign has given us more clicks and more conversions, the cost per converted click is much higher. So here it's very obvious that the second campaign is performing better. So what we will do is that for the second campaign, we will increase the budget and we will try to increase the number of leads at the least cost per converted click. So it does not matter how many clicks this campaign gets, it matters what is the cost that you are paying for a converted click. So to get good conversions and low cost per converted click, we have to create high quality landing pages which actually convert, right? So these are some of the tools that you can use to create landing pages. I personally use unbounce.com for the landing page at learndigitalmarketing.com. So you have other tools such as lead pages, instapage.com, landerapp.com, wishpond.com and landingy.com. So all these tools help you create high converting landing pages which you can use with AdWords. So even if you have a website for your company, it is recommended that you create a separate landing page which is targeted towards what type of traffic that you are driving. Let's say someone is searching for let's say Hyundai i20 test ride. Instead of driving that particular visitor to the Hyundai website or Hyundai i20 product page, what you can do is that you can create a landing page which has a form where they can fill up their details to request more information or to request a test ride. And in such a scenario, you will be able to get much more return on investment through your AdWords account than driving traffic directly to the website or product pages that you have right now. So here I am inside my Google AdWords account. To set up conversion tracking, let's go to tools and let's click on conversions. So once you are in this page, click on add conversion. So there are different types of conversions that you can track: website, apps, phone calls and import. Phone call tracking is a little bit difficult to do here in India because it does not support certain features. What we can do is that we can go with the simplest and most straightforward one, website tracking. So here I'm just entering sample conversion. So we can even enter how much the conversion is worth to our business. Let's say we are selling something on the website for $10, and for each sale, let's say we are earning $2, which means that the conversion is worth $2. This is in the case of someone purchasing something from our website. So each time it happens, action has the same value. So let's say $2 is our profit, so value is $2 for every conversion. We can count every conversion, which means that if one ad click leads to three purchases, it will count as three conversions. So in this case, we will just click on as one because sometimes they will refresh the page and it will be counted as two conversions from the same person. So we will count as one conversion. So here we have something called conversion window, which means that after the ad is clicked, how long should we track a conversion coming from that particular person. Here it is given as 30 days. We also have something called view through conversion window, which means that if you are running display ads and if someone is looking at your display ad but not clicking on the ad, and then he is going to come to your website directly and purchasing something, this is called view through conversion. So view through conversion also, we will leave it at 30 days. So you can include a category just for your own reference. Let's say this is a purchase or a sale. So include data for this conversion in your conversions column. So this data has to be reported back in our dashboard. So we will use yes. So there are two types of attribution models, first click attribution and last click attribution. Here I will leave it as last click because we want to track the last click where it came from. Basically, if you convert this into first click attribution model, Google will track when the first click came from. So we will click on save and continue. So this is the tag installation part where you have to insert the conversion tracking code in your website. So this is the tracking code. So you have to copy this and you have to place this code on the thank you page as we had discussed before. You can also email this particular tag to a webmaster's email. If you have a webmaster in your company, you can ask him to install the conversion tracking code. Click on done. And that's it. The conversion tracking code has been created. All we need to do is install the conversion tracking code on the thank you page. And once that is done, Google will start tracking all the conversions coming from your ad campaigns. So we will look at a sample conversion report, how it looks. Go back to campaigns. So in this campaign, you are able to see the number of clicks which each ad group has received and also the number of conversions that has come from each ad group. It also shows the cost per conversion. So cost per conversion is basically the simple math where it looks at the total cost spent on this particular ad group and the total conversions that has happened, and it divides the total cost by total conversions, and that gives us the cost per conversion. So conversion rate is 25%. And total 4 conversions. Here we do not have view through conversions because we are not running a display ad here. So you can similarly see there is another ad group, and here the conversion data is a little bit different. The cost per conversion is a little bit less compared to this ad group. So this is how conversion data is reported in your AdWords dashboard, and that's it about conversion tracking and landing pages. So I will see you in the next lesson. Thank you for watching this video. Bye bye.